Welcome guys, in our today's video presentation, we'll be able to talk about the part 2 of sign law. Guys, sa ating previous video presentation, pinag-aralan natin ang part 1 ng sign law, specifically the condition of oblique triangle, which is AAS, condition of oblique triangle. In today's video presentation, we will be able to talk about the SSA, condition of oblique triangle. Okay, kapag sinabi nilang SSA, condition of oblique triangle, there are given sides, two sides of the oblique triangle and one angle of the oblique triangle. Okay, bakit parang naman yatang napaka-special ng part 2 ng SSA condition? Okay. Because there is a what we call ambiguous case that is happening in the SSA condition of oblique triangle. Okay? Anong ibig sabihin ng ambiguous? Okay? Ambiguous. Kapag sinabi natin, narinig natin ang word ambiguous, it means there is an uncertainty happening, okay, in the oblique triangle. Hindi kasi natin alam, guys. Okay? Kung talagang ang mga given side at angle, okay, na problems or given side angle sa oblique triangle ay makakabuo talaga ng oblique triangle at necessary na pwede nating magamit si sign law. Okay? Hindi natin alam kung talagang makakabuo siya ng oblique triangle, makakabuo siya ng dalawang triangle, o makakabuo siya ng one right triangle only. Okay? So pag-usapan muna natin guys ang mga uncertainty na pwede nating makita sa SSA condition ng oblique triangle. Number one, okay, kaya ambiguous siya dahil pwede tayong hindi makabuo ng oblique triangle mismo. No triangles involved, okay? No triangles or no triangle. Okay? Yan ang unang uncertainty na pwede nating ma-observe mismo sa sign law. Okay? Number two, pwede siyang makabuo, okay, dahil sa mga given na side angle, pwede lamang siyang makabuo ng one right triangle. So, katulad ka ng sinabi ko guys, pwede tayong makabuo ng one right triangle only. If this is the oblique triangle, pwede lamang siyang makabuo ng one right triangle pala. Okay? Hindi pala siya ganito, hindi pala ganito ang kanyang itsura. Okay? Ganito pala ang kanyang itsura. Okay? Possible 'yon. Okay? Mamaya titingnan natin kung paano nakakabuo ng one right triangle. Paano makakabuo ng one right triangle ang SSA condition. Okay? Number 3, pwede siyang makabuo ng two triangles involved. Okay? Paano 'yon? Okay? If this is the original oblique triangle, okay? That is the original oblique triangle, guys. Pwede nating ito, ang side na to, pwede itong ma-extend. Okay? Na kamukha-kamukha ang left na ito. Okay, dito. Something like this. Okay. So dalawang triangle ang involved. The first triangle is this one, ABC. The second triangle is the A prime. This one, A, B, and C. Okay. Something like that. Okay, paano natin malalaman kung no triangles, one right triangle, or two triangles ang involved sa SSA condition? At paano nangyayari yun? Okay. Okay, magbigay tayo ng example. Okay, paper. Okay, so again, okay, suppose this is angle A, B, and C. That is triangle ABC, oblique triangle. Ang given natin is the angle A. Okay, symbol niya alpha, suppose this is side A at side C. Yan lang ang given natin. So, side angle. Side angle. Okay. Paano nangyayari, guys? Okay. Ang tinatawag nilang ambiguous case here. Hindi kasi natin alam ang side na to. Okay. Yan. Sorry. Hindi natin alam ang angle na to. I mean. Okay. Nawawala ang angle na to. Hindi natin alam kung ang angle ba ay talagang ganito siya. Ito. Okay? Hindi natin alam kung ang angle, ito ba yon. Okay? Hindi natin alam kung ang angle ay ito lang. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, guys, nagkakaroon ng uncertainty because of this angle. Okay? Hindi natin alam ang angle na to. Suppose, alam natin na ang side na to, ang side A. Okay? Pwede kasi itong marotate. Okay? Na ganito pa rin ang side. Okay? Kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng ambiguous case happening there. Now, in order for us to know if it is north triangle involved, one right triangle, or two triangles involved, kailangan nating makuha ang height. Okay? We need to determine the height of the oblique triangle. Bakit kailangan nating makuha ang height ng oblique triangle? Because we need to compare the height. Okay? This is the height of the triangle. Yan. The oblique triangle. This is the height. Kailangan nating makompare ang height na to sa opposite side of the reference angle or the given angle. Okay? So, ang first step, in order for us to determine the height, we need to have the reference angle. Ang sinasabi kong reference angle, hindi ang reference angle doon sa mismong tinatawag nilang circular function sa trigonometry. We are talking about the reference angle as a basis, as a given angle of the oblique triangle. So, in this case, the angle involved is a what we call reference angle. Tinatawag ko lang siyang reference angle. Okay. So, ibig sabihin, basis angle natin. Ang unang step para makita natin ang height, ma-distinguish natin ang height, tignan mo muna ang reference angle, ang given angle. Okay? And then, analyze the relationship of this angle to the given side, okay, sides, okay, ng oblique triangle. The relationship of this angle to this side is opposite. And the relationship of this angle to this side is adjacent. Ibig sabihin ng adjacent is katabi. Okay, ito ang katabing side ng angle, ng given angle. Ngayon, okay, una, para makuha mong height, kasi may mga example tayo, magbibigay lang ako ng example. Limbawa, binigyan tayo ng example, something like this. Okay. Something like this. Sorry for that figure. So, A, B, C. So, we have given side A, and we have given side C. And the angle is... The angle A, yan ang given natin. So, this is suppose theta. Okay. Something like that. Kung yan ang given mo, okay, i-consider mo ba, guys, na itong height, okay, ito ba ang height na i-consider mo? No. Okay, hindi natin ito pwedeng i-consider na height ng oblique triangle. Okay. Hindi pwedeng masabi natin that this is the height of the triangle. Magdedepende pa rin tayo sa mga given, okay, sa ating SSA condition. Magdedepende pa rin tayo sa given angle, given side, and given opposite side, and given adjacent side, okay, of the oblique triangle. So, how do we know where is the height of the oblique triangle? Okay? So, balik tayo dito. Okay. Ito, kinonsider natin itong height because our reference angle, we need to compare the opposite side of the reference angle A to the height. Okay? So, ang kailangan, tignan mo munang ang reference angle, okay, ang given angle, and then the adjacent side. Kailangan ito magkatabi. Okay? Ang kaharapan ni angle A, okay, na pwede mong ma-create ang height. Yon ang magiging height. Okay. So, for example here, okay, drawing lang natin ulit, okay, na maayos. Drawing lang natin ulit. No? So, ganito yun, no? Para siyang ganito, no? This is A, B, and C. Ang given natin is B theta, angle A, side A, and side C. Yan ang given natin. Tama? Nasaan ang height dito? Okay, katulad na sinabi ko, titignan mo muna ang reference angle. Ang basis natin ay ang angle. Ang given angle. So, ito ang angle. Okay, ngayon hanapin mo ang adjacent side. Ito ang adjacent side. Okay? Ngayon, nasaan ang height? Okay? Nasaan ang height na kailangan ito, okay, magkatabi na pwede nating mag-create ang height. Ito ang height. Okay. Yan ang height. Ito ang height. Okay? Sorry for that. I-draw lang natin na maayos. Yan. This is the height. Okay. That is the height. Okay. So, kung babaliktarin mo yan, para siya magiging ganito, no? Okay. Something like, kung babaliktarin natin yan, ito ang magiging base. Something like this. Okay. Sorry for that. This is C and B. That is A. Sorry. Sorry. This is A. This is C. This is C. This is B. Okay. So, ito ang magiging base. Ang base na to, ito yon. Okay? Ito yon. So, this is the height. Okay? This is the height. Okay. Now, ang given natin is angle A. So, this is just only a figure, no? Illustration, no? Okay? Then, we have a side A. We're in BC yon, no? Then we have a side C, BA, ayun. Okay, side C. So yan, makukuha na natin ang height in that case. Okay. Yun ang sinasabi ko sa inyo. Titingnan nyo muna ang reference angle, ang angle natin. Okay? Dapat magkatabi ang reference angle, ang base, ang given angle, at ang reference, sorry, ang adjacent side. Okay? At ang angle, magkatabi yan. Then we can create now the height. Okay? Now, how to determine the height? How to compute the height? So, this is the height. Okay. Now, using trigonometric ratio, we can compute the height. Okay. Because there exists a what we call right angle there. Okay. When given an angle, there is a given angle. The reference angle, the given angle, the adjacent of the oblique triangle will become the hypotenuse, okay, because the opposite angle of this side is the 90 degrees in reference to the height, okay, in respect to the height, okay, and the height will be the opposite side of the angle given, okay. So, ano magiging formula natin? Opposite hypotenuse, that is sine theta. So, sine theta equals the opposite over hypotenuse. And what is theta? That is still theta. Sine theta equals what is opposite? That is the height divided by the C. Okay, so if we have a numerical value there, we can compute the height. Okay, now what is the relationship in this case using basic algebra to determine the height? That is cross multiply. So height will become C times the sine theta. Okay, so this is now the height. Okay, let us compare the height, okay, in respect to the oblique triangle or in respect to the opposite side of the oblique triangle. Okay, number one, paano natin malalaman kung no triangle involved? Okay. So, these are the ambiguous case na sinabi ko kanina. No triangle involved. Okay, malalaman natin there is no triangle involved if the height, okay, if the height is greater than the opposite side of the given angle, okay, of the given angle, there is no triangle involved if the height that we determined is greater than the opposite side of the given angle. Okay? If this is the given angle, okay, ang opposite side niya is A. Nakuha natin si height. Kapag si height daw ay mas malaki sa A, sa opposite side ng given angle, ng in respect to the oblique triangle, then there is no triangle involved. Papakita natin, realistically speaking. Okay, this is A. Okay, this is A. Okay, yan ang given natin, theta. Okay, given natin is C. Okay, Suppose ito 'yon, no? Ito yung height na nakuha natin, okay? Kung ito mas malaki, okay, mas malaki siya kumpara sa opposite side, okay, wherein ito ang length, okay, ng opposite, sorry, ng height. Tapos ang opposite side ay maliit lang kumpara sa length. Ganito 'yon, no? Okay, o yan. Ganyan lang siya. There will be no construction of a what we call oblique triangle. Ayan. Ito yung opposite side. This is A. Okay. So, kung malaki nga talaga ang height, ito, ang height na to, kumpara sa opposite side na to, okay, meron tayong, okay, ambiguous case na makikita. That is no triangle involved. Okay, nakikita nyo. Okay. Okay, hindi niya napunan. Okay. Ang oblique triangle. So, 'yon. No triangle involved if the height is greater than the opposite side of the given angle. Number 2. Okay. One right triangle. One solution ang tawag dito ng marami, no? Or one solution, one right triangle if the height, kapag gusto nating malaman kung one right triangle ba siya, kailangan natin i-compare ang height in terms of the opposite side of the given angle. At anong mako-compare natin? If the height is equal to the opposite side of the given angle, then we have one right triangle. One right triangle, one solution, if the height is equal to the opposite side of the given angle. Okay, sige, gawa tayo, no? Realistically speaking, okay, this is A. Yan ang given natin na angle. This is C. Tapos, ito yung height, no? Okay, gamit tayong green ball pen. So, ito yung height. Okay, kung titignan natin kung ang height is equal to the opposite side in respect to the oblique triangle, magkamukha ang sukat nila, eh di ibig sabihin one right triangle lang involved. Okay. Ito kasi, hindi mo naman pwedeng ilagay dito. Dito. Okay, magkakaroon ng short line. Okay, dito. Okay. Isang angle lang involved, yun lang. Okay, para mapunan mo yung base. Okay, para makagawa ka ng triangle. Okay, if the height is equal to the opposite side, isang angle lang involved dito. Okay, hindi mo siya pwedeng i-rotate. Kasi magkukulang siya, mag-shortage siya, o kaya sosobra siya dito. Something like this. Okay, kung titignan natin. Ito 'yon. Okay? O magkakaroon siya ng sobra dito. Okay? Kaya ang height kapag equal sa opposite side, ibig sabihin one right triangle lang involved. Okay? Next, we have number three. Okay. If we want to determine, or if we want to make sure that there are two triangles involved, sorry for that. Okay. If the height is less than the opposite side of the given angle, okay, then we have two triangles. Okay, pakita lang natin, no? If this is the oblique triangle A, ito yung C, given natin is theta. Okay. Sabi niya itong height. If the height is less than the opposite side of the given angle, then we have two triangles involved. So, ito yung height, ganito ang kanyang length. Okay? Pasobrahan natin yung opposite side, something like this. Okay? Makakabuo talaga siya ng dalawang triangle. Okay, this is the first triangle. This is B, this is C. Okay. That is the first triangle. Ngayon, since di natin alam ang angle dito, ayan, hindi natin alam ang angle doon, pwede itong mag-rotate. Okay? pwede itong mag-rotate hanggang mapunta sa tamang pwesto. Okay? Something like this. Itong length na ito, suppose ito ay length A. Okay? Length A, pwedeng i-rotate to dahil hindi natin alam ang angle dito. Okay? Kapag nag-intersect ito sa base, another base, sa base na ito, another point in the base, magkakaroon na second triangle. Okay? Para siyang magiging kamukha nito. Something like this. If this one, kung ito, is side A, okay, this is side A, napunan niya doon, nirotate mo, okay, magkakaroon ng obtuse angle. Okay, so two triangles involved. Ang first triangle, something like this, this is A, B, then C. Okay, given A, theta, C, and then we have A. Okay, yan ang first, ito ang first triangle. Ang second triangle, okay, we have something like this. Okay, this is A, this is B, sorry, this is B, this is C. Okay, theta. Okay, so meron tayong obtuse, ito. Ito ay obtuse. Obtuse angle. Okay, so, palagi nating isipin, guys, na sa second triangle, palagi talagang merong obtuse angle. Kapag two triangles ang involved, meron tayong obtuse angle lagi dun sa pangalawang triangle. Okay, this is the second triangle. Okay, at talagang dalawa ang triangle natin, ang involved natin triangle. Okay? So let us have a specific example. Okay? Okay, so we have a angle A 100 degrees, side A and side B. Okay? Side A is equal to 5 cm, side B is equal to 7.7 cm. And we want to obtain what is the value of angle B, angle C, and side C. Okay, paano natin gagawin yan? First step is to determine the height. Okay, where's the height? Hanapin muna natin ang height in order for us to compare the value of height in the opposite side of the reference angle or given angle. Okay, so in order for us to determine the height, tignan muna natin ang given angle. At the same time, hanapin natin ang kanyang adjacent side. That is 7.7 cm. Okay? So, ang kaharapan niya, okay, pwede tayong makabuo ng height. This is the height. Okay. To determine the height, since we created a right angle here, okay, we will be using the sine law. Sorry, the sine trigonometric ratio. That is sine 100 degrees opposite and hypotenuse. Okay? So, sine theta, so, gamit na ko lang, sine theta equals the opposite over hypotenuse. What is theta? Sine 100 degrees equals the opposite, that is height, divided by the hypotenuse, 7.7 cm. Cross multiply height is equal to sine 100 degrees. Okay. Multiply to 7.7 cm. Yan. Okay. So, pakita natin sa calculator. Sine 100. Kailangan naka degree. Ayun, D. Times 7.7. That is 7.58 cm. Yan ang ating height. Okay. Now, let us compare the height in respect to the opposite side of the reference angle. Okay. So, in this case, 7.58 ang height natin at ang opposite side ng given angle in respect to the oblique triangle is 5 cm. We can say that the height is greater than the opposite side. Okay. Since the height is equal to 7.58, greater than the opposite side, equivalent to 5 cm. Okay? In this case, we can conclude that there is no triangle involved. Okay? No triangle. Okay, bakit? Kasi kung kikreate natin yan, ito ang height. This is 7.58, tama? This is the angle A. Okay. makikita natin guys na 5 cm hanggang dito lang yan. Okay. So, may kulang. Okay, makikita natin doon, may kulang. Okay, kung i-extend natin yan. No? Hindi niya mabubuo ang triangle. Yun ang sinasabi ko sa inyong ambiguous case that there is no triangle involved. Next example tayo, kung halimbawa, wala tayong figure. We have angle A equals 40 degrees. We have side A equivalent to 32.14 cm. And we have a side B equals 50 cm. Okay. Now we want to determine what is angle B, angle C, and side C. Okay. Yeah, no? So the first step is to construct a figure. So kung ito yon, suppose lang ito, this is angle A, B, and C. Okay. Angle A is equivalent to 40 degrees. Side A is equal to 32.14 cm and side B is equal to 50 cm. Remember guys that the opposite side of the angle B is the side B and the opposite side of angle A is equal to the side A. Okay? It's equivalent to side A, I mean. So ito, side C, ito. Yan. Ngayon, kinukuha natin dito is the angle B, angle C, and the side C. Okay? So, the first step again, in order for you to know kung anong klase siya ng ambiguous case, since S, S, A ang given natin, okay? Determine muna ang height. Nasaan ang height? Hindi itong height. Okay? Kasi pwedeng magbabase pa rin tayo, I mean, sa mga given na side at angle ng oblique triangle. Okay, ito ang angle, reference angle. Itong opposite side niya, 50 cm. So, ang kanyang magiging height is something like this one. Okay, this one. Okay, sorry for that. Ito ang kanyang magiging height. So, kung babaliktarin mo yan, magiging something like this. This is A, C, B. Ito ang height. Okay. So, meron tayong angle A, 40 degrees. Meron tayong side A, 32.14. Okay. Meron tayong side B, 50 cm. Okay. Yan. So, ito ang ating right angle. So, to determine the height, that is sine theta equals the opposite over hypotenuse. What is theta? That is sine 40 degrees equals the opposite. That is the height divided by the hypotenuse, 50 cm. Ayun ang hypotenuse. Okay? So the height is equivalent to the cross multiply of sine 40 degrees times 50 cm. Okay? Ano yun? Ano yun? Okay. So, the height is equal to 50 times sine 40. Okay. Yan. Meron tayong 32.14 centimeter. This is the height. Okay. Ngayon, i-compare natin ang height sa opposite side ng reference angle. Okay? What is the opposite side of the reference angle in respect to the oblique triangle? That is also equal to 32.14. So, the height is equal to opposite side. Since height is equal to 32.14 and its opposite side still. Okay, 32.14 din. Okay, so in this case, we have one right triangle. Okay, yan ang ating conclusion, no? One right triangle tayo. Okay, so since alam natin that this oblique triangle is a one right triangle, this will be look like this. Okay, pakita ko lang sa inyo. Okay, This is B, this is C. That is the right angle. Sorry, this is C, this is B. Okay. Ito ay 50 centimeter. We have the A, 40 degrees. Alam na natin ang height. Okay, tama. Itong height. And the height is also equal to the side A. Okay? So, meron na tayong side A. That is 32.14. Okay? Meron tayong angle A. That is 40 degrees. At meron tayong side B. 50 centimeter. Ang kinukuha natin is angle C, angle B, and side C. So, in this case, we need to use the trigonometric ratio na lang. Hindi na natin gagamitin ang sine law. Kasi right triangle naman pinag-uusapan. Okay? Kung kukunin natin si angle C, okay, makukuha ba natin? Makukuha natin because we know what is angle B. Angle B is equal to 90 degrees. Okay? Because that is the intersection of AB and BC, no? That is 90 degrees, okay? Okay, meron na lumilipad, no? Ayun, gagamba. Okay, alisin ko lang. Yan. So, we have angle B equals 90 degrees. So, para makuha natin si angle C, since we know that the sum of the internal angle of a right triangle is equal to 180 degrees, equate natin ng 180 degrees equals angle A plus angle B plus angle C. 180 degrees equals the angle A, 40 degrees, plus the angle B, that's 90 degrees, plus C. Okay? So, 90 plus 40 degrees is equivalent to 130 degrees. Okay? So, 180 degrees equals 130 degrees plus C. C equals 180 degrees minus 130 degrees transpose. C equals 50 degrees. Okay. So, yan si angle C. We have angle B. We have angle C. Ang kailangan na lang natin is the side C. Okay. Dalawa ang pwede mong gamitin sa side C. Okay. Pwede kang gumamit ng Pythagorean theorem since you have the side A, the height, and the hypotenuse, 50 centimeter. Okay. Pwede kang gumamit ng trigonometric ratio, okay? In respect to the hypotenuse and its adjacent, since kinukuha natin is this one, okay? So, adjacent hypotenuse, okay? Kaya adjacent at saka opposite. Opposite over adjacent, tangent, pwede. Madami, madami kang solution kasi right triangle yan. So, in that case, let us use cosine. Trigonometric ratio. Dito na lang, no? So, cosine theta equals adjacent over hypotenuse. Okay? Cosine 40 degrees. Okay, ayun yun. Equals the adjacent C, side C over the hypotenuse 50 centimeter. Cross multiply C equals cosine 40 times 50. Cosine 40 times 50. Okay? Approximately equal to 38.30. So that is side C. So we have angle B, angle C, and side C. That is how to solve one right triangle involved. Last example, we have angle A equals 58 degrees. Side A is equal to 11.4 centimeter. And side B is equal to 12.8 centimeter. Now, to determine what is angle B, angle C, and side C, kailangan makuha muna natin ang height. First step, let us draw a figure. Okay. So, this is side A, B, sorry, angle A, B, C. So, 58 degrees. We have 11.4 centimeter. We have side B 12.8 centimeter. Ngayon, para makuha natin si angle C at angle B, okay, kailangan kunin muna natin ang height. Okay? What is the height in respect to this oblique triangle? Union. Okay? Since itong reference angle, ito ang kanyang adjacent, kaya ito ang magiging height. Okay? So, nakabuo tayo ng right angle. So, this is sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse. Kasi opposite hypotenuse, kinukuha natin ang height. Okay? What is theta? That is 58 degrees. Sine 58 degrees equals opposite. That is the height divided by the hypotenuse, 12.8 centimeter. Cross multiply, height equals sine 58 degrees. Again, kailangan naka degree. Sine 58 degrees times 12.8 equivalent to 10.86. okay, 10.86 centimeter. Okay, ayon, 10.86 centimeter. That is the height. No, now let us compare the height in respect to the opposite side of the reference angle, 11.4 centimeter in respect to the oblique triangle. So in this case, makikita natin na ang height ay mababa sa opposite side. Okay? So the height is less than the opposite side. Okay? Since the height is equal to 10.86 centimeter, less than 11.4 centimeter. So in conclusion, we have two triangles involved. Okay? Let us draw the first triangle and then the second triangle. Okay, drawing natin ang first triangle. Okay, so katulad ng sinabi ko, ito ang magiging first triangle natin. So we have 58 degrees, A, B, and C. This is 12.8 centimeter. This is 11.4 centimeter. Okay. This is the height. Tama? Okay. This is angle B. Okay, ang second natin, ang second triangle natin, okay, kung i-rotate natin to, since hindi natin alam ang angle doon, okay, dalawang triangle na involved, hindi natin alam ang angle doon at dito, okay, pwede natin yung ma-rotate. Nakamukha-kamukha ang length ng side A na 11.4 centimeter. Okay, so pwede siyang magbukang ganito. Okay, something like that. Okay, so this is A, C, and B, wherein ito ay 11.4 centimeter pa rin. Okay? At ang B natin is 12.8 centimeter. At ang angle A natin is 58 degrees pa rin. Okay? Makikita natin sa second triangle. Okay? Para siyang nirotate mo ito, parang magiging ganito yan. Okay? Parang magiging ganun yan. Okay? Nakamukha-kamukha pa rin ang length ng side A. Okay? So, nawawala dito ito at yun. Okay? So, makita natin dito that the angle B is obtuse angle. Expect, obtuse angle yon, no? Kasi po rotation niya. Kung i-extend natin ito, makikita natin na parang original triangle siya, no? Parang magiging ganyan siya. Okay? Wherein ito, 11.4 centimeter, 11.4 centimeter din yon. This is the first triangle. Ito yon. Tama? Okay. So, kung makikita natin ito na ganito, reconsidering this, ito lang ang magiging triangle natin. This 11.4 centimeter is equal to the 11.4 centimeter dito. Makikita natin that this is an isosceles triangle. At mayroong relationship yan mamaya pag magsosolve tayo. Let us solve first the unknowns in the first triangle. What are the unknowns? That is angle B, angle C, and the side C. Okay. So to determine the angle B, okay, angle B muna ang determine natin. Bakit angle B muna? Wala tayong side C, wala tayong angle C. So we will be using the sine law here. So we have sine B to determine angle B over B equals sine A over A. we have sine. What is the value of B? We don't know. That is unknown. Side B. What is the value of side B? That is 12.8. Equals centimeter. Equals sine A. What is A? 58 degrees over A. Side A. That is 11.4 centimeter. So cross multiply, we'll be having 11.4 centimeter sine B equals 12.8 centimeter multiplied to sine 58 degrees. Okay, divide both sides by 11.4 centimeter. 11.4 centimeter. Okay, to determine sine B. So sine B equals 12.8 centimeter multiplied to sine 58 degrees divided by 11.4 centimeter. Now we need to isolate B. So mangyayari dito, we need to determine the inverse sine of this. Okay, so B equals the inverse sine of 12.8 centimeter multiplied to sine 58 degrees divided by 11.4 centimeter. Ayun. And B equals what? Later on, solve natin. Pero I want to explain bakit naging ganyan, no? Ipapakita ko lang sa inyo kung bakit naging inverse sine. Okay? Meron tayong tinatawag na unit circle. Okay? Tama? Ang unit circle, okay, meron siyang kada one unit na intersection. Ayan. Okay? Sa Cartesian plane. Okay, meron din tayong tinatawag terminal side na, ayan, ang terminal side na umiikot. Ito yung terminal side. Okay, actually, dalawa yan. We have the initial side, yung hindi gumagalaw, and we have the terminal side, yung umiikot. Okay? Kapag umiikot si terminal side, nag-stop sa isang position, magkakaroon siya ng angle. Okay? Magkakaroon siya ng angle in respect to the initial side. Okay? Ng unit circle. Okay? So, kung meron siyang intersection doon, sa unit circle, magkakaroon siya ng x and y coordinate. Okay? X and y coordinate. The intersection of the terminal side in the unit circle can form a what we call coordinate. Wherein the coordinate 1, the coordinate x, is equivalent to cosine theta, and the coordinate y is equivalent to sine theta. Okay? And the theta that I am talking about here is the theta that is being formed by the terminal side and the initial side. Okay? Ngayon, kung meron kang x and y, you have the value of x and y. Okay? And you want to determine what is theta, you don't know what is theta. Okay? Inversion. Inversion. To determine theta, for example, you have an x. Okay? You will use the cosine theta here. Okay? To determine theta, you will use the inverse cosine of x. Kung meron kang x, kung meron ka namang y, to determine theta, that is the inverse sine. Okay, that is the inverse sine of y. Okay, parehas lang yan, makukuha mo yan ang kung anong value ni theta. Pero there is no such thing in the trigonometry. Now, for example, you have the x, okay? You have the sine theta, and you have the x. Sorry, y. Okay, you have the y. You want to determine theta. Didivide mo to ng sine. Didivide mo to ng sine. So, magiging theta. Makakancel daw yon. Magiging daw y over sine. Tapos, ilalagay mo daw sa taas yung sine. Magiging theta equals the inverse sine. Magiging the inverse sine of y. Kasi daw, ito ay tinatawag the inverse 2-2. Okay, this is incorrect. This idea is incorrect. If you have an instructor or a teacher that teaching you something like this, na i-divide mo ng sine, itatas mo yan, tapos itatas mo si sine, magiging inverse, kamukha daw ng xy, di-divide ka ng x equals 1 yan. Halimbawa, di-divide ka ng x, y equals, itatas mo si x, magiging 1 multiplied to x raised to negative 1, y equals x raised to negative 1. Kaya daw naging ganon. Hindi. Walang ganon na concept sa trigonometry. Sinasabi ko sa inyo. Okay? I-correct ninyo ang mga teachers ninyo kapag ganyan ang itinuturo. Pero I am talking about the circular function. Kasi ang circular function, meron siyang explanation bakit merong inverse sine, merong inverse cosine, inverse sine. Pupunta tayo dyan, no? Okay, for the meantime, dito muna tayo sa SSA condition. Pinakita ko lang sa inyo ang preview kung bakit nagkakaroon ng inverse sine, inverse cosine. Okay? So, to compute the angle B, we have sine, the inverse sine. So, pwede mo yung ituloy-tuloy sa calculator kung meron kang kasyo, something like this, na merong fractional form na ganyan. Pero, ang kung wala, multiply muna, divide, tapos inverse sine. Okay? So, you need scientific calculator talaga. So, 12.8, ayun, multiply to sine, kailangan na degree, 58 degrees. Okay? Then, divided by 11.4. So, yon. Then, inverse sine. Shift sine. Okay? Then, the answer equals, okay, 72.21 degrees. Okay? To be exact, we can use the degree minute second. Ayon. Degree minute second. Ito, pipindutin natin, no? Yon. So, 72 degrees, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. That is our angle B. This is our angle B. Okay? Ngayon, ang sinasabi ko sa inyo, bakit naging ganyan, wala naman yata ang tinuro sa inyo, ang degree minute second ay ginagamit, isa ring angle ito, ginagamit ito sa direction. Tinuturo ko na sa inyo, in order for you to understand our topic, sa direction, terms of getting, determining, identifying the resultant vector of those vectors that are involved in the Cartesian plane. Okay? So, ganyan ang gagawin natin. Naka-degree, minute, second. Okay? So, yan ang angle B. So, makikita natin sa figure dito that this is 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Okay? Something like that. Okay? Now, meron tayong angle A, angle B. Makukuha natin si angle C. Okay? Now, to determine angle C, okay, we have 180 degrees equals, okay, the angle A plus angle B plus angle C. Remember that the total, the sum of all internal angles of any polygon is equal, sorry, of a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, so 180 degrees equals the angle A. That is 58 degrees plus the angle B. That is 72 degrees, okay, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds, plus C. Okay, pag add natin yon, 58 plus 72 degree, ayan, degree, 12 minute, and 43.85 seconds. So, we have 180 degrees, okay, equals 130 degrees, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds, plus C. Okay. So, yon, i-transpose natin, C equals 180 degrees, minus 130 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. C equals, so 180 minus the answer. Okay, we have 49 degree, 47, this is 49, 47 minute and 16.15 second. That is angle C. Okay. So we have angle B, we have angle C, and nawawala na lang is the side C. Okay. So continue na natin dito sa papel na to. Okay. So to determine side C, we will be using the ratio of sine C over C equals sine A over A. Bakit sine A over A? Bakit di sine B over B? Okay. Pwede naman sine B over B. To be exact na lang, para hindi tayo mahirapan, ang mga given na lang gagamitin natin. What is sine C? What is the angle C, I mean? That's 49 degree, 47 minute, 16.15 seconds. Okay, divided by C equals the sine A. What is A? 58 degrees over A. That is 11.4 centimeter. Okay, ito. So next page na tayo. So we have sine 49 degrees for 7 minutes 16.15 seconds divided by c equals sine 58 degrees divided by 11.4 centimeter. Cross multiply, we have c sine 58 degrees equals 11.4 centimeter multiplied to the sine c sine 49 degrees for 7 minutes 16.15 seconds. So, yan, no? So, divided by sine 58 degrees. Remember, we are talking about, ano dito, no? We are talking about the length. Hindi yung angle pinag-uusapan dito. Tapos na tayo sa angle. Side ang pinag-uusapan dito. So, side C is equal to 11.4 centimeter. So, 11.4 multiplied to sine 49 degree. For 7 minutes, and 16.15 seconds. Okay, then divided by sine 58. That is approximately equal to 10.27 centimeter. That is side C. Remember guys, wag din, kapag side ang pinag-usapan, wag nyong gaganyanin. We are not talking about angle there. We are talking about the length. So that is the approximate value of side C. So in conclusion, we have obtained or determined that angle B is equal to 72 degree 12 minute 43.85 seconds, and the angle C is equal to 49 degree 47 minute and 16.15 seconds. So yan, no? Yan ang mga nawawala sa first triangle ng oblique. Okay? So, second triangle, analyze natin. Okay? So, sa second triangle, kanina sabi ko sa inyo, parang ganyan ang ating triangle. We have A, B, and C. Okay? Yan, ganyan, tama? So, ito ay 58 degrees. This is 11.4 centimeter. This is 12.8 centimeter. Okay, so nawawala si B, si C. That is the second triangle, no? Okay, second triangle. Kasi two triangles involved tayo dito. Okay, we'll be extending this one. Okay, meron siyang tinatawag na external angle. Ito ay external angle. Tama? Okay? Okay? Since pinag-uusapan natin is the determination of C, angle C and angle B, para hindi tayo malito, papalitan ko yan ng C prime, B prime. Okay? Because we are talking about the second triangle. Now, we are not talking about the first triangle anymore. We are talking about the second triangle. Okay? So, meron siyang external angle kung i-extend natin yon. And we have this idea that if we add the first angle, sorry, the internal angle and the external angle, that will be equal to 180 degrees. Okay, that will be equal to 180 degrees. Tama? So, internal angle plus external angle, that is 180 degrees. Okay? If we will be analyzing this, i-extend natin yan. Kung i-analyze natin yung first triangle kanina, para siyang ganito, tama? Okay? Ito yon, tama? This is C, this is B. Okay? This is 11.4. Nagkakaroon lang ng second triangle dahil pwedeng ma-rotate itong side na to. Dahil di nga natin alam ang angle C and angle B, tama? Kung i-rotate natin yan, papunta sa left, something like this, okay, para siyang magiging ganyan. Where in this one, this side is also equal to 11.4 centimeter, tama? Kung kukunin natin ito, itong side na to at yung side na yon, at itong base na to, makakabuo siya ng another triangle na sinabi ko na kanina. Okay. Ito yon, tama? So, this is 11.4 centimeter. This is 11.4 centimeter. Okay? Kung titignan nyo ito, okay, ito yon, tama? Ang side na to ay itong side na to. Okay? Ngayon, kung i-extend natin ang base nito, we will be having an angle there. That is the external angle that I am talking about dito. So, second triangle. So, this is the external angle that I am talking about. Okay? Now, what is the external angle in order for us to determine B prime? Kasi alam natin, 180 degrees to. E di, kung nakuha mo ang external angle, minus mo sa 180 degrees, makuha mo si B prime. Okay. Kaso, hindi nga natin alam anong external angle. Pwede natin malaman in relation to this. Okay. So, since this is 11.4, the opposite angle of this is the B, the angle B, tama? Wherein we obtained a while ago what is the measure of angle B. So, angle B kanina is equal to 72 degree, 12 minute, and 43.85 second. Tama? Yan ang angle B. So, this one is equal to the angle B. Kung ang side na to ay kasing sukat lang ng side na to, ibig sabihin, ang opposite angle ng side na to ay the angle B itself. 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. So, the external angle here is 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Okay? Now, to determine the B prime, since we know the relationship of this, that the internal angle of any polygon and the external angle, their sum is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, so 180 degrees equals the B prime plus the B. Right? Kanina? Okay? Since the B is also equal to the external angle. So, 180 degrees, we don't have B prime. Yan ang kinukuha natin. What is B? That is 72 degrees plus 72 degrees, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Transpose B prime equals 180 degrees minus 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. So B prime equals, so 180 minus 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Okay? That is equal to 107. Ayan, 107 degree, 47 minute, and 16.15 seconds. This is the B prime, and as you can see, as you observe, the B prime is an obtuse angle. Obtuse ito, tama? Okay, so yan, nakita natin, obtuse angle, ang B prime, okay? So, we have now the B prime, and we can calculate the C prime. To calculate C prime, okay, alam natin na kung pag-a-add natin ang A, B, and C, angle A, angle B prime, and angle C prime, that is equal to 180 degrees. So, 180 degrees equals the A plus B prime plus C prime. So, 180 degrees equals what is A? Ayun, 58 degrees. Okay. Plus the B prime, 107 degree. Okay. 47 minute and 16.15 seconds. Plus C prime. Okay. So, add natin. 58 plus 107 degree. 47 minute. 16.15 seconds. That is equivalent to 165, no? 180 degree equals 165 degree, 47 minute, 16.15 seconds plus C prime. Now, to determine C prime, i-minus mo lang ito. Itong angle na to sa 180. So, C prime equals 180 minus the answer. Sorry, 180 minus the answer. So, we have 14 degree. Ayun, 14 degree Okay, 14 degree, 12 minute, and 43.85 second. This is C prime. So yun, kadali lang. Okay, nakuha na natin si B prime, C prime. Okay, now to determine the side C, side C na lang, ito na lang. Meron na tayong C prime, meron na tayong B prime. Meron na tayong C prime, B prime. Side C na lang. We'll be using sine C prime over C. Side C equals the sine A over A. Okay? Gagamitin pa rin natin sine A over A. So, sine C prime, what is C prime? That is 14 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Divided by C. Sine A, what is sine A? What is angle A? That is 58 degrees. Over A, 11.4 centimeter. Cross multiply. Then divided by sine 58 degrees. So, para siyang magiging 11.4 centimeter. Multiplied to sine 14 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Divided by sine 58 degree. Okay. So, we have C equals. So, 11.4 times sine 43 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Divided by sine 58. Equivalent to 9.20. centimeter. So, cancel ang degree. Okay, so, that is side C. So, in conclusion, so guys, in conclusion, okay, when the height is less than the opposite side of the reference angle or the given angle in respect to the oblique triangle, we have two triangles involved. And we can compute. Okay, we can compute those uncertainties or those unknowns, I mean, okay, na makikita sa dalawang triangle. So, in this triangle, we have computed that the angle B is equivalent to 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. The angle C is equal to 49 degree, 47 minute, and 16.15 seconds. Okay. Side C is equivalent to 10.27 centimeter. Okay. Yan ang ating na-compute. Okay. On the other hand, we have computed that the angle B prime is an obtuse angle that is equivalent to 107 degree, 47 minute, 16.15 seconds. Angle C prime is equivalent to 14 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. We have the side C is equivalent to the 9.20 centimeter. As you can see, guys, ang C dito, mahaba. Ito ang C. Ang length ng C ay 10.27. On the other hand, ang length ng C, since dumiit na yung length dito, 9.20 centimeter. Malalaman natin kung tama ang sagot natin in relation to the angle and their opposite side. Okay? Makikita natin dito ang pinakamalaking angle is the 72 degree, 12 minute, 43.85 seconds. Ang angle B, ang pinakamalaki. So, dapat ang kanyang kaharapan, ang pinakamalaking side. Kung i-observe natin, 12.8, 11.4, tsaka 10.27, mas malaki talaga ang 12.0 centimeter. So, ibig sabihin, si angle B dito ay tama. Okay? Dapat ang pangalawang malaki ay ang angle A. Since siya ang pangalawang malaki sa mga angle. Okay? Ang pangalawang malaki niya na opposite side o sides ay ang kanyang ka-opposite na side. Okay? Na 11.4 centimeters. So, yun ang pangalawa. 12.8, 11.4, 10.27. Same thing dito. Kailangan ma-observe natin na itong pinakamalaking side, ang opposite niyang angle, ang pinakamalaki dapat. Actually, tama yun, no? At makikita natin ng angle C, ang pinakamaliit na angle na ma-observe. So, ang kanyang kaharapang side, ang pinakamaliit ng side. Makikita natin ang pinakamaliit na side is 9.20 cm, which is the side C. In this case, okay, we have completed the SSA condition of oblique triangle. And we learned how to use the sine law. I hope, okay, talagang may natutunan kayo in terms of computing, analyzing, calculating specific oblique triangles, specifically when we are using sine law, okay, and analyzing SSA oblique triangle. Dito sa sine law, ito lang talaga ang pinakamahirap. Masyado siyang madaming ano, iniisip ang SSA condition of oblique triangle. In our next video presentation, okay, nood lang kayo guys, at huwag niyong kakalimutan mag-like, mag-subscribe, mag-comment sa ating mga video presentations. And at the same time, abangan ninyo kung ano pa ang ating mga ituturo. In our next video presentation, we'll be dealing about the cosine law. Okay? Specifically, the SAS and the SSS condition of oblique triangle. Good day, guys. Remember, God loves you.